So I think my camera's about to die, but it's been a while since I did a car ride with you guys. So hey, I hope you're having a great day. I was thinking about something at work, and I'm on my way home now. I'm finally off. But I was just thinking about something, and I thought I'd just share it with you guys. Growing up, I was the girl who had accepted Christ, but did not fully know who I was in Christ. Growth is what happened to me, but it's a day-by-day process. What you're about to watch is my life story turned into a blog. These blogs are how I reach others who know Christ, but don't yet know who they are in Christ. My name is Lauren, and I am not your average girl. I wonder why we worship God. Now, okay, if you're a Christian, then you can probably relate to this. But if you're not a Christian, then hey, listen up, because this might be something that you might be wondering too. So when we worship God, or when we give thanks to God, or when we acknowledge Him or say, hey, Lord, thank you for being so good. Have you ever wondered why God is good? Like, have you ever, and the reason why I'm asking that is because a lot of times we say, Lord, thank you for being so good because you did this for me, or thank you for being good because I could have been, you know, going through something, or I could have been, you know, something related to you. So we kind of connect the goodness of God to things that happen, or whether it be good or prevention from something bad, or but have you ever wondered what makes God good? So my camera dies on me, but I'm gonna still finish this conversation. So the question that is kind of formed from that is, or that I kind of think about, is why do we connect the goodness of God to situations? For instance, I've heard a lot of people say, and I've said it myself, God is good because He kept me from this, or God is good and I thank God because I could have been going through this, but I'm not, and so therefore I acknowledge that God is good. Okay, now that's one little testimony that you might hear often in church, or you might hear, see somebody write or something like that, which, you know, if we really think about these things, like, is that really why God is good? Because if you think about it, there are so many people in the world that go through things that they probably don't want to be going through right now, but that doesn't make God any less good. So I think it's time for us to change our mindsets as believers. If you're a believer, then you know where I'm coming from with this. I think it's time for us to change our mindsets and start thinking about the goodness of God as it reflects His nature and not His works, or not what He can do for you. Because quite honestly, things happen to people, good and bad, but that doesn't necessarily change the character and the nature of God. God is good by Himself alone. Even if He never did anything for you, He's still good. Now, because He's good, as a result of that, when we encounter Him or experience a relationship with Him, then favor follows, or we experience peace or whatever in the middle of something bad happening, or whatever the case may be. We experience the goodness of God in our situations, whether it be when something good happens or when something bad happens. We experience the goodness of God, and that's what in return gives us like peace, gives us like joy, whatever. But I just always wonder that, and I always wonder like what people think when they say stuff like that. I understand you mean well, and you know, people have good intentions when they say, oh, well, God is good. I could have been going through this, but God is good. Or, you know, I got, you know, an extra check today. God is good. Instead of connecting the goodness of God to things that happen to us, good and bad, I think what we need to do is approach that kind of thing with a more thankful heart. So instead of saying, God, you're good because of this, we should say, God, I thank you for, you know, whatever. For example, something bad happens to another family member. God, I thank you for protecting my family. But you know, and then it leads you to pray for the other people's family, because even though he protected your family, or even though your family might not have, or you might have not have experienced something as bad as someone else might have experienced it, that doesn't negate the goodness of God for the person who did experience something bad. God can still be good, just as good in their life as he was good in your life. Does that make sense? Because if we connect God's goodness to, well, we can connect it. I should say another word. If the foundation of God's goodness was because of what happens, or because of circumstance or situations, or if we say this is how we know, well, this is how we know God is good, by our works or by things that we go through. I don't know if I'm dark or not, but whatever. If we say God is good because of that, then that kind of leaves out a whole group of people that don't experience God in the same way. And so, I guess I'm challenging you as my viewer, or as the person viewing this blog, to think of God as an entity on his own, who is capable of being good without having any any relation to what happens in your life. Okay, that doesn't make sense. I'll probably cut that part out. But anyway, think of God, or when we learn about God's character, we understand what makes him good, or what drives him to directly influence our circumstances, whether it be good or bad. So, I don't know if that makes sense. Maybe I'm saying it in a weird way, but I just always wonder that. Like, we will always say, well, he woke me up this morning, he started me on my way. Well, that's not what makes him good. Like, yes, we're thankful for those things, but what makes him good is just the fact that he's God. And when we acknowledge that, then we have more of an inclination to honor God and to serve him and to reverence him as God, versus, you know, honoring a situational God. Like, oh, I could have been dead and gone. I understand that, but what about the people that are dead? Like, you know, that doesn't negate the goodness of God. Like, God is still good. And then, in a sense, when we say things like that, and then when things happen, then we get to a point where we don't really understand, or we kind of question or doubt, or we're kind of confused about, like, how God works, in a sense. Which, of course, we are in and of ourselves, we are limited and finite, so we will never be able to fully grasp God and his ways in our finite state. But you know, I just, you know, it kind of leaves out a group of people. Like, you say, well, I thank God that I'm not dead, but what about the families of the people who are, you know, who have passed away? Like, that doesn't necessarily mean that God is not just as good in their lives as he is for you. You know what I'm saying? So I guess being careful with our words, understanding what we say when we say it. Like, I feel like our worship will be taken to a whole nother level whenever we kind of think about things in that sense. And we really understand what we say when we say it, and ensure that we're giving God praise for the reasons that he deserves praise and honor and glory and whatever. But anyway, that was my rant. So yeah, if you're not a believer, then maybe you got something from that, but feel free to comment, let me know your thoughts about, you know, anything I say, or if you just want to say hey, you know, I appreciate you know, mingling with people that with those that I'm connected with. So We're in this thing together forever. Can't lose me. No, I'm kidding. Well, the videos will probably be out there forever, but anyway, I'm done rambling.
Me? He got my face as I was.
Outside. you can't hear the music.
Funny.
Girl,